If you have a slam ball, that will do. Otherwise, and again, it doesn't have to be a full bath towel. You could take like a hand or a kitchen towel. You could even take a dog toy, but just something that's easy for you to take overhead, throw on the ground if you're going to be doing that modification of the exercise, so that it doesn't bounce away from you like the other ball would. Okay, so just those three things: a towel, a knotted up towel, or a slam ball if you have it, a rubber or squishy ball, and a set of weights, a light or medium pair. Okay, cool. We've got a slightly longer circuit today, so we're gonna do kind of a quick warm up and then we'll just jump right into things. Okay. So I'll have you come back to a seated or standing grounding position of some sort. And we'll just start with our body intake here. Make sure you can all see me. Okay. So we'll close the eyes. I'm starting by coming into your breath. And I just want you to see if you can slow your breath down. So if someone were standing or seated next to you, could you make your breath so slow and quiet that they wouldn't even be able to hear you? So not forcing a slow breath, just nice and easy, just kind of bringing the nervous system down a little bit. Maybe you're even starting to feel your heart beating or hear your heart beating. And then just taking a quick scan from your head to your toes. And feel free to wiggle or shake or circle the shoulders or the neck around. But I just want you to notice where in your body you're holding some extra tension, or maybe where in your body feels uncomfortable, maybe even painful right now. And then where in your body feels really good? Where do you feel strong, mobile, comfortable? And I want you to put one hand over the painful, the sticky, or the uncomfortable area. And I want you to put one hand over the strong, the comfortable area of your body. Okay, so just holding the part that feels good, the part that doesn't feel so good. And then just take a few breaths into these two areas. Just bouncing your attention from the part that feels good to the part that doesn't feel so good, breathing into that, and then letting it go with your exhale. And let's just do a couple more breaths like that. Yep, one more breath. Good, go ahead and set your intention for class today. We'll release the hands, we'll open the eyes, and we'll take both arms, we'll reach them up to the sky, interlace the fingers if you can, pushing up, take an inhale, and then exhale, articulating down as low to the floor as you can. And we're just going to pause at the bottom, take a couple of breaths here. And on that last exhale, articulate yourself back up. Arms reaching up, and then arms are going to reach behind you. Same thing, interlace the fingers if you can. Otherwise, just open the chest, open the collarbones. Good, and then give that a little bit of a shake. Okay, we're going to move the head around so arms can just be relaxed. Let's just start with a few head and neck circles here. Remember to try to not throw your head back on these ones. So staying within a controlled range of motion for you and for your neck. Yeah, and then switch directions. Noticing what parts of your neck feel a little sticky, maybe feel a little tight or restricted. Okay, and then coming back to the center, good. We're gonna reach the arms up to the sky again, shrug the shoulders up, take an inhale, and then exhale, just let your arms fall down to the floor. Mm-hmm. You're just gonna let gravity take them. Inhale, reach up and shrug up, and exhale, let everything fall. Yep, a few more like that. Inhale, reach, 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 make it active all the way out through the fingers, and exhale, fall. That's it. Inhale, reach and shrug. And exhale, fall. Yeah, last one, last one. Inhale, reach and shrug. And exhale, fall. Awesome. Okay, we're gonna bring both arms in front. Let's find a few book openers here. So sliding left hand down the right arm across the chest, turning and rotating so you're looking behind you. And then drawing the arm back across the chest, down the arm, and back to the center. Good. Switching sides, opening the book, rotating, and then closing the book back to the center. And if you can, making sure that you're dragging that hand all the way across the arm and across the chest. It just helps bring some awareness to that area. And just moving at your own pace, going back and forth, opening the book, rotating, and then closing the book. Let's do one more. Opening the book, rotating, and closing the book. Good. We're gonna keep both hands together. You can interlace the fingers if you're able to, or just keeping your knuckles together. Okay, you're gonna bring your hands up up and to the left, and then down and to the right. Yep. And then bring the hands up and to the right, and then down and to the left. Yeah. And we're just drawing a huge X in front of your body, one diagonal and then the other diagonal. And I just want you to move through that. Maybe keep your eyes on your hands. If you're standing, you can bring that down into a squat. Just moving slow at first. Just giving you a prep here because we're going to be doing some wood chops in class today. Okay, so just drawing a nice big X in front of you. Maybe inhaling as the arms raise and exhaling to cross. Inhale, raise, exhale, cross. Yeah, there we go. Nice, everyone. Let's do a couple more there. And last one. Good. Okay, we're going to set your hands on your thighs. And we're going to find a lean forward. For those of you standing, you're just going to keep your knees bent like you're in this ready coaching position. And hands are going to be on the knees. Okay, so leaning forward, putting the weight, you can either do it through your elbows, if that's more realistic for you, or through your hands. And then you're gonna turn, keeping both hands on the tops of the thighs, you're gonna turn and look over your left shoulder. Take an inhale into your right ribs, and then back to the center. Good, push into the other leg, turn and look over the right shoulder. Take an inhale into the opposite ribs and then back to the center. Mm-hmm. Good, turn, rotate, take an inhale and exhale center. Push, turn, rotate, inhale, exhale center. Yep, rotate, inhale, exhale center. Last one here, rotate, inhale, and exhale center. Good, we'll come up back up to a seated position. You're gonna bring the hands together one more time. And then we're just gonna do a couple of big circles around the body. So again, interlacing the fingers or just keeping the hands together. Hands are gonna be down by your left, drawing a big arc up and over your body and then through the center. So I'm kind of drawing that arc in front of my knees if you can reach it. It can also come across your lap if that's easier. And you're just gonna continue with that big circle, up and over your body, reaching, coming down, coming across your lap, and continuing on. Similarly with the breath, let's inhale to lift the arms and exhale to circle down. Inhale up and exhale, circle down. Yeah, and then we're gonna switch directions. Inhale and exhale. Inhale and exhale. Yeah, do a couple more in this direction. Try to get as much rotation through your torso as you can. Good, and I'm coming back to the center. Let's shake the arms out. Shake the hands and the wrists out. If you're standing, you can shake the legs out. Yeah, awesome. Okay. So we've got a few circuits today. We've got our main circuit. And I'm just going to copy and paste this one more time for folks that joined us a little late. Okay, so we've got, we're starting with a Tabata circuit of burpees. Remember, Tabata circuits are 4 minutes. And I'll, where you're working 20 seconds on and then you're resting 10 seconds. So it's supposed to be kind of a fast-paced work, rest, work, rest, work, rest for 4 minutes. And you're gonna do that Tabata circuit at the beginning of the workout and at the end of the workout. Okay, like always, you're just gonna move right from one circuit into the next. So it kind of turns into like one 18-minute long circuit or so. You're then gonna move into the main part. So the circuit, the 10-minute circuit, as many rounds as possible, and you have 4 exercises. And then you're gonna finish with that Tabata circuit at the end. Okay, so just as a few reminders for new folks that are joining us. For my seated athletes, if you're doing burpees for the Tabata circuits, you're gonna be leaning forward, tapping the floor or as close to the floor as you can, sitting upright and clapping overhead. Yeah, and feel free to practice these with me as I'm talking you through. Leaning forward and clapping overhead. You're trying to move as quickly as you can through that one. For my standing athletes, make sure I'm in the frame here. If you're unable to get down the floor, you're gonna be doing something similar, tapping the ground, standing up and clapping the hands overhead. Okay, if you are able to get down on the floor, you're gonna place the hands down, step or hop the feet back. You can add a push-up here if you're able to. Step or hop the feet back in. And then as you jump, you clap the hands overhead. So a simultaneous jump and clap. Okay, so then moving into the rainbows. Okay, so for the rainbows, you're gonna grab your ball. If you wanna make it harder, you can also grab a weight. I'm gonna use a ball today, but it's up to you. Okay, so holding your ball, just like we did in warm up, you're gonna keep that ball down towards your left hip, bringing the ball up and over like you're drawing a rainbow or an arc over your body, and then up and over back. Really what I care about here is your rotation. So every time that ball comes down and taps the outside of your hip, I want you to try to rotate your chest towards that as much as you can. Up and over, tap and rotate. Like I'm trying to point my chest at that ball each time I turn and rotate. Yeah, there we go. That looks good, everybody. For standing athletes, you're doing the same thing. You're just lowering down into a squat and tapping the ball on the floor each time you come down. Okay, but same overall movement. Okay, wood chop slam. So these are the ones we haven't done yet. You have several variations. For the rainbows, you're doing 12 total. Okay, for the wood chop slams, so a couple options. For my seated athletes that are unable to pick something up off the floor. So for example, if you throw something on the floor, having to adjust my camera here. If you throw something on the floor and it's hard for you to reach it, you're gonna stay with wood chops. So holding the towel or the ball or whatever is easy for you to hold, you're gonna lift that towel up to one side and then quickly chop down and to the other side. Up and left, down and right, okay? So you would do 8 wood chops on each side, just like that. For seated athletes that are able to pick something up off of the floor safely, you're just gonna turn this wood chop into a slam, okay? So overhead, and then throwing it down and to your right, picking it up again, using one hand or both hands, again, whatever safest for you, picking it up, raising, quick down and a quick chop and throwing it down. Okay, so how quick and how hard can you slam that towel knot down on the floor? So you would do 8 on one side and then you would do 8 on the other side. For my standing athletes, you're doing the exact same thing. You're just gonna be standing. I don't wanna hit anything here. Standing, throwing it down, and then coming into a squat to lift it back up, okay? So same exact thing. It's okay, bud. Same exact thing, but you're doing it from a standing in a squatted position. My family dog got very concerned with that one. Okay, you're doing 16 total. Third exercise, tricep dip and squats. Okay, so again, a few variations here. So for folks that are able to do a tricep dip using the chairs of their wheelchair, okay, so pressing up and down like that, or if you're coming off of your chair, off the front of your chair, and doing a tricep dip like that, you have that on there. For seated athletes where that isn't super accessible, you're going to be coming, oh wait, I'm going to have you grab. Well, it's up to you, depending on your weight situation. If you can just grab one heavier weight, you're going to come into a strict overhead press. If you have 2 lighter weights, you can do both weights and just pressing both weights directly overhead. Yeah, so that's for seated athletes that aren't able to do the tricep dip. And then lastly, for my standing athletes, you're going to be doing a front rack or a front squat. So holding the weight at your collarbones, dropping down into a squat, and then standing all the way back up again. Keep that weight at the height of your collarbones the whole time. You're doing 16 total for those ones. Okay, fourth and final exercise, reverse flies. So grabbing your lighter weights, finding the hinge forward, palms facing in, and then opening and closing into that T position. Find control through the whole range here. And then for standing athletes, same thing, but just doing it from a standing hip hinge position, slight bend in the knees, but same movement otherwise. And you're doing 12 total. So easy way to remember the reps, 12, 16, 16, 12. 12, 16, 16, 12. Okay, when you finish that 10-minute circuit, remember to count how many rounds you get through. You're gonna jump right into one last Tabata circuit. So I'm gonna turn off the music, or at least turn down the music. We'll do one last Tabata circuit, 4 minutes of the burpees again, and then you'll be done. Okay, so make sure you pace yourself for this one because it's a little bit longer. And you've got a Tabata circuit in the beginning and at the end. Okay, just making sure my towel is knotted here. I think that's it. If you have any questions, let me know or unmute yourself. Otherwise, we'll get going. We're gonna start with a Tabata circuit, so I probably won't do music for that one, but then for the middle circuit, I'll turn the music on. Okay, so remember, 20 seconds on, 10 seconds off. Burpees, pace yourself here. You've got 18 total, but 4 minutes for this first Tabata circuit. Okay, here we go. On your marks, get set and go. 20 seconds on, 10 seconds off. You're trying to squeeze as many burpees as you can into each set of 20 seconds. For 3, 2, 1, and relax. OK, Okay, 10 second break. It always feels easy in the beginning, so pace yourself here. 3, 2, 1, and go. Three, two, one, and stop. Okay, 3, 2, 1, and go. You're 1 minute in, everyone, 1 minute in. Three, two, one, and stop. 10 seconds, which always flies by. 3, 2, 1, and go. Yeah, nice work, everybody. That looks good. Three, two, one, and stop. You're halfway there, 2 minutes in. Just gonna show you the standing version. 3, 2, 1, and go. Three, two, one, and stop. Three, two, one, and go. Three, two, one, and stop. You have 1 minute left for the Tabata. 1 minute left for Tabata. Three, two, one, and go. Three, two, one, and stop. Three, two, this is your last set, one, and go. Last set for this Tabata circuit. Three, two, one, and stop. Nice, everyone, good work. Okay, you got 10 seconds off. Go ahead and grab your ball. You'll go right into that 10-minute circuit. You're starting with rainbows, 12 rainbows, and then 16 of the wood chop or the wood chop slams. Okay, here we go. Second circuit starts now. Remember to count how many rounds you get through. Starting with the rainbows and then moving through those four exercises. Again, find a pace where you still have a little bit of energy left for that last Tabata circuit. I'm gonna join you here. I'm just gonna share my music. Can people hear that?
You. Now every other day I'll be watching you. Oh.
You're 3 minutes in, 3 minutes in. You're 4 minutes in, a little over 4 minutes in, 6 minutes left.
Just dance, gonna be okay. Oh. Da-da-doo-doo, just dance. Da-da-doo-doo, just dance. Oh, yeah. Gonna be okay. carve it out, work it, hustle.
I got it, just stay close enough to get it.
Don't slow. Dive it, clean it, lights out, bleed it, spend the last dough.
I got it
in your pocket.
Left, last 2 minutes. Remember, try to keep your form, but push yourself here.
I was wondering, you know, if you could keep on, because the force, it's got a lot of power, and it makes me feel like it makes me feel like it.
Okay, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, get a few more in, 4, what comes after 5, 3, 2, 1, and relax. Nice work, everybody. Okay, you can grab some water if you need. We're jumping right into the last circuit, last 4 minutes here, and then I promise we're done. Same thing, we're going to Tabata for 4 minutes. So you can see the equipment. We're gonna go right into this. Take care of yourself if you need to. Otherwise, here we go. 3, 2, 1, and go. Back to burpees. 20 on, 10 seconds off. And stop. Three, two, one, and go. And stop. 1 minute in, everyone. 3, 2, 1, and go. Three, two, one, and stop. Sorry. A couple seconds late on that one. 3, 2, 1, and go. Three, two, One and stop. You're 2 minutes in, everyone. 3, 2, 1, and go. Three, two, one, and stop. Three, two, one, and go. Stop. Okay, this is last minute. Last. 3, 2, 1, and go. Stop. This is the last 20 seconds. Last 20 seconds. 3, 2, 1, and go. Last one here, everybody. One and stop. You must understand the touch of your hand makes my fall. Okay. Let me just make sure this music is off. There we go. Okay, great, great. Okay. All right. Hey, nice work, everybody. Go ahead and grab some water. Feel free to type into the chat box how many rounds you got for that middle circuit, or you can unmute yourself and or share at the end. We will do a quick cool down and then we'll be done. Yes, awesome. The San Francisco VA vet, vets did 3 rounds times six. Oh, times six people, okay. They were impressed with those who did standing burpees. Reminds them of boot camp training. That makes a lot of sense. Awesome. Cool. Thank you for sharing, VA. We've got Kenzie with about 4. Nice work, Kenzie. Bonnie with 3.5. Solid workout today. Yeah, thanks, Bonnie. Good work. Cindy with 3 sets. Nice work, Cindy. Claudia with also 3. Good job, Claudia. And then Sheila was lost in the numbers. Yes, there was a lot of numbers and a lot of circuits. All right. Feel free to keep sharing. Otherwise, I'll have you come back to a seated or standing position. Good. Let's just start with some nice, easy neck movements here. So I'm just going to have you turn your head and neck to the left. And then turn the head and neck to the right. Just looking in both directions, left and right. Back and forth a few times. Bring your eyes with you. Good. And then coming back to the center. And bring the hands up to the sky, tuck your chin into your chest. Find an articulating roll down. Pause when you get to the bottom. And same thing, take a few breaths into the backs of your ribs. On your next exhale, find a slow, steady roll all the way back up. Reach both. up to the sky, circle the arms back behind you, in front of you, up and around. Inhale up and exhale around. Yeah, just a couple more. Inhale up and exhale around. Good. Okay. We'll close the eyes. Seeing if you can slow your breath down, quiet your breath. And then I want you to bring your attention to those two spots you held in the beginning of class. And let's just hold those same spots again. So the spot that didn't feel so good for you and the spot that did feel good for you. And just take a few breaths holding those two areas and notice if there was any change comparatively to the beginning of class. Good. Go and think of one thing you're grateful for today. We'll take one more inhale, one more exhale. We'll release the hands. We'll open the eyes. Thank you so much for joining me today, everybody. Happy Tuesday. I'll stick around if folks have any questions. Oh, did I miss some? Hang on. Sorry, I missed some numbers. It sounds like we also had some dogs.